It's a new month, and I do hope you started it off on a peaceful note, especially because today, the first Tuesday in March, is observed as Peace Day here in Jamaica. From peace in schools to handling disputes, we have you covered in today's edition of Jamaica Magazine. We'll also update you on issues coming out of the 2016 general elections. And later, Friday, March 4 is Jamaica Day in schools all across the island. Why the celebrations? Welcome, Amandra Chisholm. The magazine unfolds right now.
There'll be a better tomorrow. 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 There'll be a day. There'll be a way. There'll come a time to sing a brand new song. There'll be a better tomorrow.
Good day, I'm Lorraine Mendez, and this is your JIS News for Tuesday, March 1. The Electoral Commission of Jamaica, ECJ, is reporting that the integrity of Jamaica's electoral system is intact. At a press conference on Monday, Director of Elections, Orit Fisher, explained why the final count overturned preliminary results for the St. Mary's Southeastern constituency.
Someone who should have gotten 100 and odd was given the lower number, and the person who should have gotten the lower number got the 100 and odd. So it was a simple transposition error in that constituency on one of the boxes. And that accounted for the majority of the difference that was erased, as you have put it.
In the final count, the PNP's Dr. Winston Green got more votes than the JLP's Dr. Norman Dunn. Dr. Dunn has, however, requested a magisterial recount. The EOJ will now advise the Governor General that based on its count, the JLP captured 32 of the 63 seats in the lower house. And stay tuned to Jamaica Magazine for more details on the press conference hosted by electoral officials. The increase in the national minimum wage and the minimum wage for industrial security guards takes effect today. The national minimum wage will move from $5,600 per 40-hour work week to $6,200. For industrial security guards, their wages will move from $8,198 per 40-hour work week to $8,854. The firearm premium allowance for industrial security guards will also move to $44.30 per hour. And their dog handler's premium allowance will move to $29.80 per hour, while the laundry allowance increases to $40.30. The insurance coverage for security guards killed or injured in the line of duty will move from $2 to $2.5 million. Tax Administration Jamaica TAJ continues to assist hundreds of small businesses and self-employed persons to fulfill their tax obligations by March 15. That's the deadline for persons to file their income tax returns for 2015 and their estimated returns for 2016. Persons participating in the TAJ's Special Taxpayer Assistance Program are reminded to take their business-related documents, including taxpayer registration numbers, bank statements, purchase invoices, expense receipts, sales records, and utility bills to verify their income and expenses. TAJ is also reminding persons to utilize their online platform, the Revenue Administration Information System, to conduct transactions. Visit jamaicatax.gov.jm for details. Chairman of the Students Loan Bureau, SLB, Anthony Luars, says there's been an increase in the amount of money collected for loan payments.
Our collections have increased from approximately $1 billion in 2011-2012 to $2.1 billion for 2015-2016, or close to, or a little bit above 100%.
In the meantime, Mr. Luars says the Bureau is now able to lend money to over 90% of students who apply for loans. He adds that the decline in interest rates and rates being calculated on the reducing balance have increased the attractiveness of the SLB. Mr. Luars was speaking recently at a function where HeartTrust NTA contributed $100 million to the revolving loan fund to assist students pursuing tertiary education. And finally, local businesses are urged to register for the Tourism Linkages Hub's Speed Networking event by Friday, March 4. The event will be held at the Hilton Rose Hall and Spa in Montego Bay, St. James on Thursday, March 17. It provides an opportunity for local suppliers to have face-to-face discussions with tourism stakeholders. Registration forms are available at the Jamaica Manufacturers Association, JMA. For more information, interested parties can call the JMA at 922-888-023 or the Tourism Linkages Hub at 920-4926-30. And that's it for JIS News today. I'm Lorraine Mendez. Thanks for watching.
Got animation skills? Then come on out to Kingston 2016 and show off your talent. It's March 12 and 13 at the Edna Manley College of the Visual and Performing Arts. There will be amazing prizes, a film festival, animation competitions, seminars, and pitch competitions. Come and learn from the best local and international animation experts and engage investors in speed meetings. Kingston 2016, March 12 and 13, put on by the Ministry of Science, Technology, Energy, and Mining. Key partners include the World Bank, Caribbean Development Bank, Jampro, Toon Boom, TV Paint Development, Wacom, Ezurom, the Jamaica Information Service, and Endomani College of the Visual and Performing Arts.
The results of the country's 17th general elections and the operations of the Electoral Office of Jamaica have been hot-button topics over the past few days. The EOJ has been responding to the burning questions. Let's hear the answers in this next feature.
Last Thursday, February 25, Jamaicans went to the polls to vote for the political party they believe should form the next government.
On election night, what is called a preliminary count takes place so that the nation can be given as early as possible that night an idea of how the results are expected to pan out.
That preliminary count showed that the Jamaica Labour Party, the JLP, won 33 of the 63 seats in the House of Representatives. The People's National Party won the remaining 30. However, that's not the end of the process. Section 45 of the Representation of the People Act states that a final count should begin in each constituency the day after the elections. In this case, the final count began on Friday, February 26.
It proceeds continuously with each returning officer examining each ballot box, using the election, and reconciling the number of votes validly cast, the number of rejected ballots, the number of spoilt ballots, and the number of unused ballots to ensure that every single ballot is accounted for.
During this process, two constituencies gained national attention, that of St. Mary Southeastern and St. Thomas Western. Let's begin with St. Mary Southeastern. It turned out that in the final count, the PNP's Dr. Winston Green got more votes than the JLP's Dr. Norman Dunn. But why did the preliminary results show otherwise?
In tallying the votes, the statement is done up and given to the agents. In this case, all the statements were done correctly. However, in writing the results on the box, there was some transposition error on one of the boxes, where someone who should have gotten 100 and odd was given the lower number, and the person who should have gotten the lower number got the 100 and odd. So it was a simple transposition error in that constituency on one of the boxes. And that accounted for the majority of the difference that was erased.
Dr. Dunn has, however, requested a magisterial recount. That means a resident magistrate's court will again tally the votes in St. Mary Southeastern and determine who got the majority. The decision of that court is final. Now to the constituency of St. Thomas Western, contested by the JLP's James Robertson and the PNP's Marsha Francis. Normally, the final count happens in the respective constituencies.
But what we found was that a number of persons were gathering for that count. And with the opposing parties outside, the tension was spilling over into the count. And therefore, I thought it prudent, and that office is fairly small, and the way it is positioned, it would not be very accommodating in terms of crowds. And therefore, I thought it prudent to move the count into Kingston, where we would have much more space and much more control. but it's the same returning officer and staff who is conducting the count.
In the end, the JLP's James Robertson was declared the winner for St. Thomas Western. The EOJ will advise the Governor General that based on its count, the JLP captured 32 of the 63 seats in the lower house. The Director of Elections has also dismissed rumors that ballot boxes have been tampered with, thrown away, or went missing during the 2016 general elections.
On the night of election, the electoral office and every returning officer must account for every single ballot box and the material used in each polling station. The report that you get, that the public gets, is given on a box-by-box basis. And so any box that is missing would be known on the night of the poll.
And Jamaica has received high praises from the Electoral Observation Mission, EOM, of the Organization of American States for the way in which the country's 17th general elections was conducted. Mission Chief Janet Bostwick said she observed several good practices which could be beneficial to other countries in the region.
The EOM wishes to commend the professional conduct and diligence of the poll workers, supervisory personnel, and security agents who facilitated the voting process on both days.
The Electoral Office of Jamaica, ensuring elections are free and fair.
Let's celebrate Jamaica to the world. Fastest man in the world. First Jamaican woman to win gold in Olympic 100-meter sprint. An upcoming global superstar. Mouth-watering meals. And a vibrant set of people. We are Jamaicans. Let's get together and bring back the love. As you already know, Jamaica Day was originally scheduled for the last Friday in February, but because of the general elections, it was pushed back to this Friday, March 4. So, on Friday, students, teachers, parents, and other stakeholders will proudly wear their black, green, and gold. We give you a quick insight into the reasons behind this annual celebration.
Vegetable rundown, banana cake, caramel pudding, drops and gizzard.
And which one of them is your favorite?
Drops.
It helps you to remember back on the history so that you may celebrate and be respectful and appreciated of what happened in the past.
A display of black, green and gold, smiling faces all around, vibrant performances and all things Jamaican on display. This is how students across the island celebrate Jamaica Day in schools each year.
As a country, we are continuing to move in the right direction in ensuring that our culture through Jamaica Day remains one of the flagships of the Ministry of Education and by extension the rest of the country.
Jamaica Day is part of the Culture in Education program, which is run by the Ministry of Education. It dates its first observance in schools to the year 2001. The aim?
Jamaica Day is an annual event designed to contribute to citizenship education and to enhance the appreciation for Jamaica's rich heritage and culture, which builds positive identity in our students and by extension, our nation.
It includes stories about the tenacity of our ancestors, our heroes, those who fought and triumphed in the face of great adversity. Those who have imparted in us that indomitable spirit and will to be great in everything we touch, whether it be sport, music, academia, the arts, or any other pursuit.
The theme for Jamaica Day each year starts with the phrase, celebrating Jamaica.
Yes, celebrating what makes us unique as Jamaicans, what makes us stand out. What makes everyone else around the world have to agree that we liko, but we talawa.
we are reinforcing the fact that Jamaica is more than just a one-day public showing. It is more than just a grand concert. This year, our theme is Celebrating Jamaica, Promoting the Arts. When we hear of the arts, we think of dance, drama, music, drawing, painting, the visual and performing arts. This year, we have asked our schools not to limit themselves to these areas, but to also focus generally on the cultural and creative industries.
As the mother said, out of many one people.
So where why?
Buy five of them for $1,000. Think them can't rob me.
So Uncle Fancy, is the same $1,000 you would spend to get the six? Seriously?
Tell them again you're my math brains.
Math count.
Sponsored by the Ministry of Education.
Today is Peace Day, and we'll share with you ways in which students can be peacemakers.
The Ministry of Education is on a mission to promote peace in the nation's schools, creating an environment condemning all acts of violence while encouraging children to be their brother's keepers. And even though it's an ongoing thrust, the ministry has set aside a special day every year, Peace Day, embracing the PALS program for peace and love in schools. The Jamaica Information Service shared in the occasion in 2013 with two inner-city schools, Denhamtown Primary and Tivoli High. Denhamtown Primary came alive during Peace Day 2013. That sentiment was also echoed through the use of the scriptures, Psalm 34, verse 12.
Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from speaking deceit. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith.
Jamaica need peace now more than ever. And right here at Denhamtown Primary School, we need the peace going. This is one of our roles, especially from the Guidance Council, right? To teach the peace, have the peace, and portray some peace as a mentorship to them.
This mentorship exercise is spearheaded by a committee which comprises members of the Jamaica Defense Force and the Christian Lawyers Fellowship. Mentorship is done from all possible angles, inclusive of group and individual counseling. A club called the Beacons for Peace and Achievement, BPA, has also been established within the school.
The Beacons for Peace and Achievement overall works across the 14 parishes of Jamaica, but predominantly in the parishes of Kingston and St. Andrew. We work with youth groups across Jamaica through the National Center for Youth Development, approximately 600 youth clubs across Jamaica. So we work with inner city schools and inner city communities targeting unattached youths.
The BPA babies, who are students at Denhamtown Primary, mirror the work of the main organization by trying to maintain a peaceful environment. That's one of the scenarios that administrators are trying to avoid in the nation's schools. So, how to avoid that sort of physical confrontation?
Ask for something that you want. Do not steal it. And be satisfied with whatever it is that you have.
Sometimes I encourage the children to stop the fighting and all of those stuff and to do the opposite of war. And the opposite of war is peace.
From today, my community is important to me. I shall do what I can to strengthen it against crime and violence. This is my promise.
All the people them with a war, Zig V, hold up your hand. Zig V in the Caribbean territory, but we now want that virus take set pan we. So make sure send us stagnant water inside and mash up all my state of breed inside. More hole in the tin them where you dash by and change the water in your vase every day. No later, dispose of your garbage proper. You know them the tin them with country and backer. Tour your community and tour your yard for suppress mosquito. We half a go hard. Dash with old tire turnover drum pan for prevention is the greatest weapon. And special shout out to pregnant ladies, protect yourselves and protect your babies. Draw for your zapper and your mosquito spray. If you do all that we can for keep them away. How in a war, Zig V.
Talk it out. Don't fight it out. Remember that saying? Yep, I sure do. As we continue to talk about peace and unity, we encourage you to take note of this next feature and adapt some of the strategies in your communities.
John, what happened to the pond? I'm on the way.
I want to catch my money.
Lorian, this don't look proper. It don't sound good. This can cause death, it can cause bloodshed. There is a better way to do it. There is a better way. Just sit here.
Just listen, man. What happened?
I get my partner, John. He's not working out. All in the walk and gamble. I'm going to put it up to buy my people them book for back to school. And when we're going to try, I'm too to talk down with it.
All right, John. Yeah, she said,
Shut up, gambler. Regular, I'm a gambler and gear for pay the partner.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the money and say, I invest. I'm back to school and nothing, go on.
Yeah.
I'm losing my first pound. I'm going to buy a nice second pound. How should I go on, sir?
All right. Now, listen to me now. You see, because I'm listening to the two of you. You see, John, I hear that thing that you're just saying. You see, you can't go invest in that cash spot, John. The number must play mask, don't you lose?
Yeah, but you're playing at 5 o'clock.
No, how you sure you're playing at 5 o'clock?
Because I know I'm a sure number.
No, John, I better you go buy some onion and some peas and go to the coronation market, so John, because you're sure for sell something. You see, if I have that powder onion, you're sure of that more than the cash spot number I play. You see? So the idea for do them things this time, because you want to use them things. You see, so here we know. More of the item just look into them one another and see so why you're wrong and just admit to her so you're wrong. But we're not fighting thing no more, because that's not going to work. You see, so more of the item just be allow the item and just come together, admit you're wrong, and just call it a day. You see, I just go over a little more and boom, bam. You see? So look more, when we come back, everything must nice. All right, cool.
John O'Lorraine, you don't say for real. But guess what? You have $500 left in the bank. Buy a 9 5 o'clock pan.
Buy a 9 5 o'clock pan.
Just call them, man. You talk about the onion. You lend me a money, make me buy some onion and come over. Come here and try back in 9 5 o'clock pan.
And you don't must win. You don't must play.
Sure, all right. Here, I'm going to use the $500. Just make it up and we'll buy some onion and try it.
Well, better you do that then.
So I come with my one, man.
The underlying reason for the peace slowly taking over is the Dispute Resolution Foundation's We Want Justice program. It was a very ambitious project to help community members resolve conflicts in a harmonious way. 10 communities were selected, Tivoli Gardens and Trench Town in the corporate area, and other communities in Spanish Town, Maypen and Montego Bay. But it was no easy task for the DRF members, going into communities, convincing angry, dejected residents that alternative dispute strategies could be used to resolve their issues. With the support of the European Union, the staff of DRF was determined that the project must be a success, that the objective of creating peaceful communities must be met. And so, community members were trained. About 500 persons were given lessons in mediation, restorative justice, negotiation, and arbitration. At the workshops, they were also exposed to human rights and governance matters. Upon completion of training, community members signed a memorandum of understanding, agreeing to promote a peaceful manner in resolving conflicts. The process has been rewarding. A number of residents are trained mediators, peacekeepers, as they are called by neighbors who live within the communities. For more information on the We Want Justice program, or for more details on alternative dispute methods and training, contact the Dispute Resolution Foundation, 5 Camp Road, Kingston 4, or telephone 906-2456 or 908-3657.
When I look in the mirror, sadness looks back at me. Will my life go carelessly?
But even with the sadness and fear, the word of peace I will share.
I choose peace. I choose to live violence free.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with, I leave you to fill in the blanks. Let a spirit of peace and unity reign in your community, and by extension, in this beloved land of ours, Jamaica. While you do that, please share your feedback by sending an email to jamaicamagazine@jis.gov.jm and keep in the know through our website, jis.gov.jm. Until next time, I'm Andrea Chisholm. Have a great evening.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.